Hello students, so in today's session we shall discuss the answers or solution for the problems which we have posted yesterday. So we have posted the questions yesterday on second unit and transformers. Hope many of you would have solved that. If in case you have any doubts, you can look out for the solutions here, right? So the first problem is a 200 kVA 3300 watt 240 volts single phase transformer has 80 turns in the secondary winding. So what we need to calculate is the maximum value of flux, secondary current, then primary currents on full load, and then the number of primary turns. So for that, simply we have to use the transformer ratio, that is V1 I1 equal to V2 I2. So we know V1 V2 here. Alright, we need to find out I1 and I2. For that you can use the transformer KVA value given over here in this problem. So when we equate V2 I2 and V1 I1 separately with 200 KVA, we can get the values of I1 and I2, and from that we have given that 80 turns is for the secondary winding. So from that you can calculate the primary winding turns, and then when we substitute in the EMF equation, E2 equal to 4.4 into F by N2, we have all the values here. So we can take E2 equal to V2, since it is an ideal transformer. We have given the problem already, assume ideal transformer. So we can substitute that and we can find out the answer. The second question, it says that transformer has 500 primary turns and 3000 secondary turns. The primary voltage is 240 volts, determine the ideal transformer. Right. So for that, again for the ideal transformer, V1 by V2 equal to N1 by N2. When we substitute all the known values, what we will get is, we will get the value of V2 as 1.44 kV. Right. This is a very simple problem. The third one is, a 5 kVA single phase transformer has turns ratio. So it is fed from a 2.5 kV supply. So the full load secondary current is given. Minimum load resistance should be calculated. The full load secondary current, minimum load resistance, and primary current at full load, all these things need to be calculated. So you know the formula here. The same, these are all problems based on transformer ratio. You can apply the very same formula here and you can find out the result. So when you equate V2 I2 to the KVA, the voltage is given as 250 volts. The 250 is being obtained from this transformer ratio, and then for the minimum value of load resistance, you can take the calculated I2 value and substitute here V2 by I2. You will get the minimum value of resistance, and from that you can calculate the primary current by using the same transformation formula. Next problem is somewhat similar type. So here they have given you a transformer rating. Number of turns of the transformer has been given here. Previous problem, the turns ratio was given. Here the number of secondary turns has been given. They are asked you to find out the primary and secondary current, number of primary turns, and the maximum value of flux. Right. So with this, the transformer ratio we can find out again. V1 I1 equal to V2 I2. With this, how much they have given? The value is 100 kVA. So substituting that in this equation, you can find out the primary and secondary currents here, and you can find out N1. N1 is 2000 turns, and then based on this, you can find out the flux value, and then you can find out all things that is asked in the problem. The fifth problem is, they have given a iron loss component here, and they have given the power factor. So first, you have to take up this iron loss component. So the total resistance, they are calculated here based on the transformation ratio. Alright, these are all the data given in the problem. And then iron loss they have taken there, and copper loss they have calculated using the value of calculated resistance of RE. So at full load, the total load will be 1. The XB notes the total loading, so it will be 1. So 1 by 1 here. In case of half load, it will be, you have to take it as 0.5 or half. So you have to substitute this formula. This formula is there in every standard textbook we have discussed in class. So when you substitute this, you know the copper loss component, you know the iron loss component. When you substitute this, we can find out the efficiency for both cases, that is full load at 0.85 power factor and half load at 0.85 power factor. The next is, here they have given, in this problem they have given the core loss component, they have given the apparent power, that is the VA rating, they have given the maximum value, this is the peak value they have given, and they have given the N value. So assuming sinusoidal flux, we need to find out power factor, ion current and magnetizing current. So this core loss can be obtained by using this formula. We need to resolve this I5 into two components, IM and IC, which we need to find out at the end of this problem. So first, using this formula, we will find out what is cos theta C, or the power factor of the coil under saturation. So by using, substituting these known values, we can find out the power factor. And then from this we can find out I5. Please keep in mind that this is the value of peak voltage given. You have to find out the RMS voltage from this, which will be peak voltage divided by root 2. And then we can substitute and find out the value of I5. This is the total magnetizing component, which is resolved into copper component and magnetizing iron component, two components which is resolved into. So this you can find out as cos theta C, and this by substituting it with sin theta C, and substituting in the same formula you can find out, right? So these are the important types of problems. There are other types, the other problems are more or less affined to these types which are discussed here, right? So you can refer to this, and if in case you have any doubts, you can reach out to us. We'll be more than happy to help you. So hope you would have understood the type of problems discussed in this session. Okay, so we'll see you in the next.